support on this tournament.
Thank you.
We got, this is Tim Laurent. We're going to do men's 4-0 match here. And in talking to the teams, got a little information on them. As Alan's explaining the rules of the matchup today, we've got David in the dark blue hat. We've got his partner, Rich, in the black headband. And then we've got Lowe. He is, as I can see, he's got the blue shirt on. And his partner, Vang, who has got the black t-shirt. Fun up from Bang, he really got involved just in order to lose some weight. He heard it was a fun sport. He says he's already lost, just been playing for about 8-9 months and lost 25 pounds so far. I hear that a lot. I can attest that that is the reason why I got started. It was just to lose a little weight, and then next thing you know, I was addicted to such a great sport. And Bang's partner, Lowe, he's in the blue shirt. Lowe plays over in Cottage Grove, and he got involved just recently, actually, to pick up a sport with his wife, and to do something that they could do together. So really, it's just become a started as something they're just having some fun with, and now here they are, center court, men's 4-0. So they're having some fun with that. And the big thing here is, a lot of people get involved for one thing, and then they just find out you meet so many great people in this sport. And if it sounds cliche, well, it's just true. Have a great time, laugh a lot, enjoy the company. So that's a good reason to play pickleball right there. So we got Dave with the black cap on and the Adidas black shirt. He is, got involved here 2 to 3 years ago, and also has three daughters, he told me, and plays around locally here in town, Maple Grove. He's from Maple Grove, but so that's, and he actually got started. His neighbor had a pickleball court, and they were asking what this sport's all about, so they just started playing in a neighbor's backyard and having some refreshments, and next thing you know, like everyone else, he starts picking up on the sport and having a great time. So just enjoying himself. Rich here also plays with the black headband on. He's a local gentleman as well that Dave is partnering up with. A lot of people you can't see here, actually. We've got probably 75, 80 people watching on the other side of this court here, so. Just get through the warm-up. Again, the facility here, Rogers Tennis Club, great job, great facility here. Actually got our stuff all set up, and people play here all year long. So that's fantastic. Looks like we're getting ready to get started.
Zero, one.
So in case you didn't hear that, it probably hit off his hand, but a hit off the hand is okay as long as it's below the edge of the, as long as it's below the handle. So the tip of the handle at the base, that is the determining factor. If it hits your hand below that, you're fine. As long as it goes over. Being in the blue shirt here, being a lefty, stacking. Let that one go.
Second serve.
Bang set himself up well for that one. Got him to pop it up. Put it away.
1-1-2. Point.
Nope. Rich was taking care of business there. Paul came under the booth here. He's still spinning.
2-1.
Choose to go with the drop shot there, loaded.
2-2-1. Thank you.
had to try and redrop that. The kicks would have been a better choice, but they kept good pressure on him. Scoop. Oh, they fought back well. Low had a good scoop there, just couldn't get it quite finished off. That and paid the price. Communication is very important in this. Quite get that drop shot to settle down in time. Shot. Dave just pushed it right back behind him. Great shot. Thank you. Good choice. Hit it where they're not. Paddle up for that. Way to push him deep. I like the way they move that point around. Moved it from side to side and just stepped in and put it away. Good dinking on that. Keeping pressure on them. Finish that one off. Low had a really nice block on that. Nice job on Lowe to have his hands ready. Put it right down to the court surface. Awesome job. First game. Got it too high, too deep, put it away. We forget how many times, just a slight foot fault. Thank you. really like Vang's got nice touch to drop that soft in the kitchen, keeping him off balance a little bit with that shot. Stop that much. Ten, 10. Good game. Men's 4-0. Oh, good setup. Good play. Impatient there. Just got a little impatient. Yep. Side out. All right. Got low on the serve. Around to Ernie. Hit it out. Good setup. Good finish. It was a good flip. Catch him off guard. Hard to defend that. Game. Good game. Good game one. A few kitchen faults in there. That's what the ref is for. And it's something where it's hard to see in the heat of the battle to know if your toe went on the line or not. But that's what the ref is for. And made a difference. Both teams had them. So, give you a, I'm just gonna take a break here and I'll be right back. We're looking forward to, so we are doing, just you know, we've done 4-0 doubles here today. We're doing all the gold medal matches will be done on this court. We'll be doing that as we progress along during the day. We're going to have different levels. People can see different games. So, but it's a great game. So I'll be right back.
Seconds. 15 seconds. declares this is the start of game number two. Time in, 0-0-2. Second serve.
Bangs in the serving. Good setup. You just put it away.
Second server, my turn.
Little microphone fell off the net there. We got it taken care of. Just surprised him a little bit.
Three, four, two.
defended the first few hard ones there. It's the right call. Good sportsmanship.
5-4, 4-5.
Good sportsmanship. They just referred back to the ref to see what he's seen. Made the adjustment. Off the kitchen line, which is great. Timeout.
The 1 minute timeout. Score is 7-5-2.
So we'll take a time to thank our sponsors: North Star Pickleball, my pickleball coach, Continental Diamond, Minneapolis Cider Company, down in Dinkytown, Northeast area, Acacia Pickleball, the official shoe of USA Pickleball, fantastic shoes, Procanex. We also have CBD Wellness is here today, and has some great products for people to help those aches and pains. We also have Anderson Pickleball Coaching Academy, Chris, who's here today as well, and Craftsman Home Improvements for all your home improvement needs. Thanks for being here, guys. Thanks for supporting the tournament. And it looks like they're coming back off of a timeout. Just a reminder, we got serving now is Rich. Got Rich and Dave on the near side, and Low and Vang on the far side. Oh, great block by Low. Able to get that one, that fast shot defended. Good eye, let that one go. A little thinking battle, but he just didn't get the Rich just didn't get the lob high enough over his head or time it quite right. Oh, we had Dave had the shot he wanted. There's that thing called execution, which we all struggle with from time to time. Shot, they can be tricky. We have a timeout.
1 minute timeout, score 7-7-1.
60 second timeout. I'll be right back. Good job waiting in the center. Got the left to use a forehand in the center there. Vang with a good. Good reset off of the ground there. Two out of three, Low and Bang have to win this to bring it to game three.
Seven,
Dave was able to get that pack across. That was... I think they're both surprised. Wish the couple. Game point. Flick shot, that was a nice shot. Just surprised him with that little flick shot. Good shot, Rich. That one went. He missed the last couple, but that one worked. Chance to win it here, and they need this to extend this to game three. This game, they go into game three. So, see if I can bring on someone here. Got a second? All right, yeah, go ahead. Here we go. Well, hey, I've got David O'Neill here from Minneapolis Cider Company. I'm Tim Laurent, but you guys just put in some new courts, right?
Yeah, absolutely. We've had we had two indoor courts for a while, and we just opened up two brand new ones. We've got four total right now.
Are you bringing more in?
Tim, that's always a question. Tim asked me when we first got our courts, and he's like, we need more courts, David. So I think I'm going to keep getting that until we have a whole warehouse full. So.
Well, yeah. Well, why stop there, right?
Exactly.
I can tell you, it's a great venue, awesome facility. It's right but down in the Dinky Town area, northeast.
Yeah, kind of right by University of Minnesota, northeast Marcy Homes area. So we've got plenty of parking, really quick access from 35W.
Fantastic. Well, David, thanks for being a sponsor here and glad to have you here.
Absolutely. Cheers. All thanks for having me.
Thanks. Take care. Stepping up and helping to sponsor this tournament. So game three. Just got it too deep. Just too much, too high. Got the put away. Kept his foot just off the Nomali line as well. Takes so little to push this ball out. Even though there's no wind. David with a nice driving shot that dropped low below, right after the net.
4-0-2.
Just out. Changing sides. Just one of those shots we shoot it right at the person and got the result they were looking for. And that's not easy, banging his very quick hands.
Yep.
Nice little touch, just a little top spin on the dink. Good time to take a timeout. Obviously things aren't going your way. Now let's take a timeout and defuse that. Defuse the situation. Get back on the winning side of the scoreboard. So again, today is the men's and women's doubles. Tomorrow there'll be mixed doubles. So we'll be live broadcasting here until the event is over today, and then we'll be on tomorrow. I believe right around 9 o'clock again, until we wrap it up. But we're gonna have a lot of pickleball yet today. So let some people know if you're in the have a chance to throw something in chat. Let us know where you're watching from and how the volume and everything's okay. Let us know how that's going. Appreciate the feedback. Oh, couldn't lay out the fast one. Right between them, down the middle, solves the riddle. So true. So important to keep it down the middle. On the scoreboard there. Just kind of shot it to the other side of his body. It's a good shot. Kind of a misdirect. Good shot right down the center, good setup. Well, it's gonna be a little bit of a long haul here for the comeback in this, but it's happened before. As a matter of fact, Ben Johns and his brother Colin had come back from 10-1 to win a gold medal match in Chicken and the Pickle. That was a year and a half ago. So it's never over till it's over. Those back. I know how that feels all too well. Well, that's how it starts, one at a time. Rich able to respond to that hard hit. That's a lot. Here we go. One more chance to win. This will be for a match point. Yep, just got that too deep. Back a little too high and deep, and they were able to put it down the center. Good hands, Rich. Able to block that. Let him with that little flick shot. It's a tough shot. Flick it to their dominant hand that they're using with their paddle. Hard shot to defend. Going to drop in the last couple. That's going to be a match. Give me a match. Here we go. Well, that brings us to the next segment here. So we'll be a big matchup coming up here. And we'll let them get warmed up. We'll be right back.